few people spend more time around airplanes than the pilots who fly them. No matter how much you think you know about flying in the modern world, there are probably a few things you have never realized about air travel that pilots wish you knew. Are they really sleeping in the cockpit or flying on autopilot? The truth may surprise you. There are airplane myths and there are facts. Ahead, check out some of the things your airplane pilot never told you, but that they wish you knew. Welcome to yet another weekend edition of Trap Shots by NK. Please subscribe to my channel in case you still haven't. Also press the bell icon to be notified on the next video. Some people think pilots aren't truly flying the plane because of autopilot. But that's just not true. Think of autopilot like cruise control on your car. Just because you can set a constant speed, it doesn't mean you just stop paying attention. Does the thought of turbulence make you want to cry? Better pick that early flight. Since the heat from the ground causes bumpier air, pilots suggest booking the earliest flight possible before the sun heats up everything to get the smoothest ride. Thunderstorms are also more likely to occur in the afternoon, not the early morning. Your airline pilot would never say the engine just failed, but they might say one of the engines is functioning improperly. But don't worry about it too much. The plane could fly normally with one engine down and you would never even notice it. 7500 may be the worst to hear. The code means the plane has been hijacked or that hijacking is imminent. A pilot will say 7600 if they experience radio failure or loss of communication. 7700 indicates a general emergency. During crisis, a major issue is the pilot's failure to properly communicate the issue at hand. There is more than one reason you're not allowed to use your phone on the plane. While a single cell phone signal isn't enough to mess with airplane communications, one pilot pointed out that 12 people trying to dial home at once could lead to a false reading on the instrument panel. Plus, putting away phones and laptop means they won't fly out of your lap and hit someone in the head during a bumpy landing. Even if you purchased a pricey ticket online, there is a good chance you are really flying with a regional carrier that was outsourced by a major airline. Why does it matter? According to one pilot, a smaller regional airlines aren't held to the same safety standards as the big guys, and the pilots may not have as much training or flying experience. It doesn't mean you're going to crash, but it's frustrating to know that you're paying top dollar for an inexperienced pilot. If you picture a giant lightning bolt sending your plane plummeting to the ground, you're wrong. Airplanes are built to withstand storms and can totally handle a stray lightning bolt or two. If you hear a big boom and see a quick flash while you're flying, it's possibly that you just got stuck, but your pilot isn't worried about it, so you don't need to either. So the next time you fly, you have clearly demarcated what are the myths and what are the facts about flying. If you have had any weird experience, please post it in the comment section. And also do like and share this video with your friends and relatives. I hope you liked this video. Till the next one, signing off NK.